Okay, so the next game, I get to choose. It's I think I my list of games is a bit not that well known, but like the games you've choose.
I choose only almost only mainstream games. I think you have some hidden gems there, and I really like that you choose that type of games, because some of them I don't know them at all, so it's a way for me to discover new games.
Yeah, but still I consider them important now after all these years for that period. So this game I got in contact for the first time on PC, and it had a demo disc on also on the Level magazine in Romania, and I've played a lot that demo. It is really difficult. It's a game that it will frustrate you, so you need to have some passion until you get the hang of it. But it really blew me away, the graphics, the style of graphics that it had for that time. And in that period I still played a lot of this type of games. Let's not keep the suspense anymore and talk freely about this platformer, which had I think version only on PlayStation and PC, if I'm not mistaken, and which I got it again a few years back, maybe 10, because I wanted to play the game. I've tried on PC, but I didn't like the way it looked on the LCD and stuff like that, and I said I want to play this game on the CRT, on the old console, and I found out that is also on, available on PlayStation, and it's a really good version, and if you have a CRT, it looks amazing, this game on a CRT. So the game is Heart of Darkness, guys. You will fight a lot with some dark creatures from darkness or something like that, as I remember. I will move on myself to show you also the manual. I will show you again.
I also have some cool art for the cover art.
Yes. And you will see how good this game is looking for that period. What we are used to have is like playing an animated movie.
Yeah, it seems that it's developed by a French developer company, and from what I know, the French guys are really good at their art style.
It's developed by Ocean, which was a big, really, or distributed. I'm not sure. Anyway, Ocean was a big company back in the day, another defunct one, and they had the stamp of quality, let's say. I remember, and this is from before 95. I was looking to get my hands on games made by them, because they were really cool. I was sure that are quality. Special moves, climbing again is a game in which you'll want to use the manual sometimes. Some tips. So I didn't play the game in the last few years, but let's see how it will work. It could be pretty difficult, the game. So let's go to the game, no?
Yep. Let's do it.
Again.
We can't get enough of this sound.
Heart of Darkness.
Okay, so it's from 98, I see.
Amazing studio. Amazing studio, but under the cover of Ocean.
Yeah, the Amazing Studio is the French company, it seems, that developed the game.
Let's see now. I really think the PlayStation is the best platform to play in our days this game. Because it's really hard to from the compatibility point of view to play it on PC. I'm not even sure the game is released on GOG. Maybe you can check this. But yep. I don't think it was digitally released.
That's too bad.
When the music is, I don't know, remembers me the
movies from adventurous.
The, yes, but that style from the movies from Back to the Future, and if you remember.
In GOG there is a Heart of Darkness, but I think it's a different game. It's the Heart of Darkness, so I don't think it's the same one. It's a JRPG maybe.
No.
So no.
It's
so
not this the same.
This one no, you cannot find it on GOG. Well,
come back here this minute, young man.
No way, Jose.
There's an eclipse of the sun today. There'll be a test about it tomorrow. I'm warning you.
Freedom! Yippee! Hey, whiskey.
Cool graphics, no?
It looks like a cartoon.
They put some effort into this.
Yeah. Can tell. The solar eclipse.
The Heart of Darkness.
Yeah. Whoa, the dog is missing.
Yeah, you need to have some motivation, no?
Yeah, you need to find your friend. Whiskey.
Andy, come in the house. In a minute, boy.
Oh, they took their time with this video.
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, for the 1998, is from 98 the game.
Yeah, I think it's incredible. Difficult. Well.
Okay, so look how cool it looks even when you play on gameplay.
Wow.
And the sound is amazing. Wow. The sound is amazing.
And the shadows. Yeah. Now I understand what you are talking about.
You need to be quick with these ones, because they kill you instantly, almost.
It's very good looking.
Ah! As I told you.
Yeah.
One mistake and you're dead. But now... Fortunately, you have
some time to.
Yeah, but I think here you have it's another solution. You cannot kill it, as I remember, like that. You need to.
Okay, so it's a puzzle.
Yeah, all.
Everything is a puzzle, right?
Yeah. All the fights have some. Specific things. And the game is not that long, but until you find everything that you need to do, you lose a lot of time.
Wow. They were very creative with this one. And the physics are very good.
Yeah, it's really cool. But really hard also.
It's hard, but the game engine, I think it was very advanced for that time.
For a 2D game, yes.
It's amazing. Yeah, it's hard, all right. Oh, so the guy follows you in different scene.
Yes. Okay, so I managed to kill it. Let's see. Okay. Oh my god.
How can you manage that so many?
But you have, you see, in every screen you have a checkpoint because they know it's pretty hard. And now you yes. need to alternate.
Yeah, so you need to fight on both sides of the screen.
And it's starting pretty tough.
Yeah, from the beginning. It's not a child's game. Wow, you were close.
And you see, they try to avoid your weapon because that's why they are.
Yeah, it's, I mean, they are jumping on the.
And they're.
And they get on their knees and yeah.
And a pretty unique type of weapon also, and fighting.
Yeah, the,
really creative. Yeah.
Yeah, the physics of the game is impressive.
Oh, not Whoa. A good idea.
Yeah, but they're gonna follow you in this screen. How many enemies on the screen? I don't think I saw in these old games. There are so many rendered in the same time.
Yeah, you get the feel at some point.
Yeah.
How to kill them.
We are getting better.
And anyway, on PC it's much harder because you don't have the control joypad, so you do this from the keyboard and
wow. You were so close to be cut. Impressive.
And yeah, you don't need to, you lose so much time, you need to be pretty quick. As I remember. Ah, pretty tough.
Yep.
I just hope that we can make a. I'll make it a bit later, a bit more in the game, to advance a bit more. But this is how you play, because if after you know the game, I think you can finish it in 1-2 hours. Mm-hmm. But otherwise, it will take you a lot of time.
Yeah, you need to
for
get
the first time. Ah.
You got it.
Ah, one more try and you just need to believe us with this one to give it a try, because it's a great platformer even if it's hard. Yeah. Okay. I advanced, but I didn't finish it. I think I'm pretty close to the end of the game, but I didn't finish it yet. So maybe, I don't know why I like these hard games. yeah. So give it a try, guys, because if you invest some time, all these things that are hard in the beginning, it will give you a lot of satisfaction when you get the feeling how to fight, and it's a quick. You need to be pretty quick. I stayed just to see the demo. I hope it's a demo. I don't remember. Or it's again the movie. If there is the movie, tough luck. Anyway, start thinking to the next one, Cristi.
Yeah, sure.
It's the movie. So I will stop it.
So, yeah, they spent a lot of time on the movie, so they want to see it more times.
So until you think about this next game that you want to choose, let's take a look how this game was received on the Romanian magazines. I know for sure there are some articles about it, at least for the PC version. So let's see how it was received. Okay, so now let's see what Cristi wants to do next. Where we go next is the sixth game. It will be the sixth one, I think.
So, this time around, I'm gonna choose a game from Japan. So we had So many games from that specific area, and now I'm gonna choose another one, but it's a really, really good one. This game changed a little bit how the story is told in games. It was very good in creating some characters and the motivation of characters and the story itself. It was really well told. This game that I'm talking about, I Not sure, Alex, if you already know which game it is.
Yes,
you,
I already
you do.
I already know, and I will have a little surprise for you before starting the game, but I will let you continue the presentation if you want.
Yeah. This game was created and directed by a famous Japanese game developer that now has his own studio, and he recently created a few years ago a really impressive game. And I think we are ready to go ahead with it. And
I've told you that I've met the guy in Cyberpunk. Because the guy is Hideo Kojima, no?
Exactly, yes. Is the legendary Hideo Kojima.
And the game that he released, I think 2 years ago, was Dead Stranding. I have the collector's edition. It's a really big one. I think it's the biggest.
So you have the Norman Fetus.
Yes, almost as big as the Cyberpunk collector's edition. Anyway, as I told you, I have a surprise for you.
Okay. I'm ready for it.
Okay. So, I will not show you the game that we'll be playing tonight, but I will show you the remake for it. So.
Well.
Now, you know the... The game
looks
is
very cool.
Is the first Metal Gear Solid, which, as it happened also with Resident Evil, the first Resident Evil, was remade for the GameCube. It seems that Nintendo wanted to steal some of the success from PlayStation.
Yeah.
And it came in on two discs, the remake, which was pretty rare for GameCube games. As you know, now, if we talk a bit about the GameCube had these mini discs, and which they only covered, I think, around one and a half gigabytes. That was the space storage for it. So this is the remake for the Metal Gear Solid, and now it's debatable which one is the best. Many say that you really need to play them both, because they've changed also the actors, no? In the remake. That's the big problem, because graphically it looks much better, of course, the remake. And again, still on that era GameCube, we have manuals. But
the same problem with Silent Hill as well. The remake have different voice actors, and that's
but that was the remaster, not the remake. Here we are talking about the
remaster. Yeah, you are right.
So theoretically they could still use the same actors. Here it was a remake from the ground up, and I think it's missing some dialogues, so the first Metal Gear, even if it was remade, it's still relevant today. Okay, let's go to the game.
Let's do it.
So the third Metal Gear, the first Metal Gear Solid, the third in the series, if you consider also the first two from the 80s.
First one is from 1987, made by Hideo Kojima himself.
Let's see the intro. And remember, we are in 1998. Pretty cinematic stuff for that year.
Yeah, they invested a lot in this game.
The nuclear weapons disposal facility on Shadow Moses Island in Alaska's Fox Archipelago was attacked and captured by Next Generation Special Forces, being led by members of Foxhound. They're demanding that the government turn over the remains of Big Boss, and they say that if their demands are not met within 24 hours, they'll launch a nuclear weapon. You'll have two mission objectives. First, you're to rescue DARPA Chief Donald Anderson and the president of ArmsTech, Kenneth Baker. Both are being held as hostages. Secondly, you're to investigate whether or not the terrorists have the ability to make a nuclear strike. Stop them if they do.
What's the insertion method?
We'll approach the disposal facility by sub.
And then?
We'll launch a one-man SDV. After the SDV gets as close as it can, dispose of it. From there on, you'll have to swim. High-tech Special Forces Unit Foxhound. Your former unit, and one that I was a commander of.
So they're still around.
There are six members of Foxhound involved in this terrorist activity. Psycho Mantis, with his powerful psychic abilities. Sniper Wolf, the beautiful and deadly sharpshooter. Decoy Octopus, master of disguise. Vulcan Raven, giant and shaman. And Revolver Ocelot, specialist in interrogation and a formidable gunfighter. And finally, in charge of them, Foxhound squad leader, Liquid Snake.
Liquid Snake?
The man with the same code name as you. The nuclear weapons disposal facility covers the whole island. I'll instruct you by codec after you reach your target.
Anyone going with me?
As usual, this is a one-man infiltration mission.
Weapons and equipment OSP?
Yes. This is a top secret black op. Don't expect any official support.
The game is full, and I mean really full of cinematics and a lot of dialogue. I think the second one has one of the longest cutscenes in history of gaming or something like that. It was completely insane.
Yeah, Kojima is well known for this type of story-driven games.
Now I recommend you to play the game at least on normal, but I will put it on easy because I want to try to advance more, so not have any problems. The graphics are amazing for PlayStation 1 and the year in which it was released, 1998.
Yeah, look at these angles, so very cinematic.
This was something else back then.
This is in Game Engine.
Yes.
Down a couple of bombers and flies.
This is Snake. Colonel, can you hear me?
Loud and clear. What's the situation, Snake?
Looks like the elevator in the back is the only way up.
Just as I expected. You'll have to take the elevator to the surface. But make sure nobody sees you. If you need to, contact me by codec. The frequency is 140.85. When you want to use the codec, push the select button. When we need to contact you, the codec will beep. When you hear that noise, press the select button. The codec's receiver directly stimulates the small bones of your ear. No one but you will be able to hear it.
Got it. Okay, I'm ready to go.
Another level of quality in acting, if you remember the Resident Evil.
Yes, this is next level.
It's really quality. I think I can go under and, here.
And also the credits that are rolling and you are playing, this is something that you've never seen before. It's so movie-like.
I don't know how I kill this. I can kill this one or I need to just...
For who is not aware of this game, this is a stealth game.
So I can go without killing it, no?
Yeah.
I need to go to the elevator.
Exactly, yes.
I have another one that's coming.
Yeah, so if you are playing up on the right.
Yes, the radar. If you are playing on hard, you don't have anything. So. Huh? Oops. Oops.
Yep. In this type of game, the enemies are alerted by noises, but they are not immediately engaging. So they are in an alert state, and after that they're gonna start shooting if you don't do anything.
Okay. I need to hide. So I need to hide somewhere specific. This is not how you are supposed to play the game.
I think if it's the first time you play it, it's absolutely normal to...
I played the game,
but everything becomes harder when you... Yeah, I think it's a good idea to hide for a little bit.
Okay.
So the guy, okay.
I've told you that we need to play on easy, just to show more. But I recommend you to play on normal first time and then even on hard. But anyway, the story is amazing and acting and...
Yeah, we don't want to spoil anything because it's a quite complex story and it should be enjoyed. Yeah, I can't get enough of this angles and in engine cinematics. I love it.
And this is one of the games that I'm on the lookout for it. I want the big box PC edition. It's really expensive and hard to get. Just for the look, I mean. I love the graphics. I can imagine someone from which is much younger will say, what's up with these crazy old guys?
Yeah, there's nothing good about this graphic. Yeah, but you need to judge them by their age.
I think you need to have to live that times.
I'm in front of the disposal facility.
Excellent, Snake. Age hasn't slowed you down one bit.
How's that sneaking suit working out?
I'm nice and dry, but it's a little hard to move.
Bear with it. It's designed to prevent hypothermia. This is Alaska, you know.
Take it easy. I'm grateful. If it weren't for your suit and your shot, I would have turned into a popsicle out there.
An anti-freezing peptide, Snake. All of the genome soldiers in this exercise are using it.
I see. I'm relieved to hear that. Already tested, huh? By the way, how's the diversionary operation going?
Two F-16s just took off from Galena and are headed your way. The terrorist radar should have already picked them up.
Behind D. Colonel, what's a Russian gunship doing here?
I have no idea, but it looks like our little diversion got their attention. Now's your best chance to slip in unnoticed.
Oh man, they pushed the PS1 hardware to the limit with this one.
There are only 18 hours left in the deadline. Pretty early in the PlayStation 1.
You must be crazy to fly behind in this kind of weather.
Yep.
Time.
Who's that?
Oh, sorry. I haven't introduced you to yet.
Yeah. I think we can talk even after on the dialogues, because there are too many. We'll not have time to say anything.
It's an honor to speak to a living legend like yourself. What's wrong?
Nothing.
They are pretty long.
World-class designer of military technology to be so cute.
You're just flattering me.
No, I'm serious. Well, I know I won't be bored for the next 18 hours.
Come on. I can't believe I'm being hit on by the famous Solid Snake. But I'm surprised. You're very frank for a trained killer.
Looks like we both have a lot to learn about each other.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to learning about the man behind the legend. But first, let me explain about your Soliton radar system. The right dot in the middle is you, Snake.
Maybe Christy, you tell us a bit about the series. I will lower a bit the volume from the game.
Highly developed senses of hearing and vision due to their gene therapy. Make sure you don't let them see.
So first, I want you to this is a running series, we can say, but it has some ugly history or so.
Get whatever information you can from him about the terrorists. If he's alive, that is.
Yeah, so let me check if I can find the list of all of them. There are, as you said, running series. Even though the last one was a little bit sad with what happened with Kojima leaving Konami and with all of the drama. Don't know if you want to get into it, but it was pretty terrible.
I know, I think it's pretty well known that Kojima is not anymore with Konami. It has he has his own studio and already launched the Death Stranding game. And there is a rumor, you know, that Kojima is working to a new Silent Hill. You know something about this?
Yeah, I know. That's a little backstory. So in his last year in working for Konami, he wanted to try something else, a different game beside the famous Metal Gear series. He was working for so long on this series and he wanted something new. And Konami didn't want him to try something else because this is the main game. They get a lot of money from this series. but he managed to convince Konami to let him try a little bit on reviving the Silent Hill series that for so long they didn't have a good Silent Hill game, and he released the PT demo, if you know. It was released on PlayStation 4, I believe.
I played it.
You played it. It was incredible. It's so masterfully done. So I think it's the best demo game ever made, in my opinion. The PT demo made by Kojima for Silent Hill, with a lot of hidden stuff. But enough about Silent Hill. The sad thing is that he didn't manage to finish the project. He was unable to work with Konami anymore. There is like a famous, we don't know for sure if it really happened like that, but it seems that for the final game, I think it's, let me check which Metal Gear Solid was. Do you know what's the last one?
I think Metal Gear Solid 5, Phantom
Pain, right?
Yes.
I think that one from 2015.
I think it still was another one, but really, really bad. That bad that 3-4 years ago, it was another Metal Gear, but I wouldn't include it in the series.
What I was talking about is that on the last one, Hideo Kojima didn't want to continue working, and Konami forced him by separating him from the team and working for a few months locked in an office with some crazy stuff was going on in that time. And the result of that was him leaving the Konami, and the Silent Hill project was abandoned. Konami unpublished the demo from the PlayStation Store. For some time was some PlayStations that had installed the PT demo were sold like with crazy amounts of money.
Because it was the only way you could still play this game if you had it installed. Unfortunately, I've sold my PlayStation 4 that had the
PT demo installed.
But I didn't take advantage of this. I sold it before this. I sold it when I got the PlayStation 4 Pro. And unfortunately, I died also here.
Yeah. Going back to the story, and the rumors that you said, in the PT there was some in the final scene of the demo, it was Norman Reedus as the main player. As you know, in Death Stranding is the same guy in the Norman Reedus is the main character from that game, so they kept the relation, and now is rumored that his team is working on a new Silent Hill. I'm hoping that it's true, and the Silent Hill franchise needs someone like Hideo Kojima to revive that series. As I told in the Silent Hill game, I'm a fan of the series, and that would be awesome. But it's
I wanted to say that it's interesting how the games that we choose are somehow related.
And yes, they are related in more ways that we thought.
I mean, it's something that we discovered now in the show, with all the relations. It was nothing planned.
Yep. Yeah, and you were asking about the game. So this one was followed after Metal Gear Solid 2, Sons of Liberty from 2001. That one was released on PlayStation 2 and 3, also on PlayStation Vita, together with Xbox and Xbox 360.
It was a remaster, I think, for PlayStation 3, Xbox 360 and PlayStation Vita. I have the PlayStation 3 and PlayStation Vita versions.
Yeah.
I don't know where I need to go here.
After that, in 2004, Metal Gear Solid 3 was released, the Snake Eater, as well on PlayStation 2, 3, Vita and Xbox. And it seems that also had a Nintendo 3DS version, the third one.
Yeah, but usually these versions are pretty different than...
yeah, sure, you could not have...
It's like another
Nintendo
game.
Nintendo 3DS to run something like this. It's impossible.
I can kill this guy? You remember?
I think you can, but not in this state that he is alerted. He will gonna shoot you. You need to take them when they are not aware of someone is there. Okay, so in 2008, the fourth one, Metal Gear 5, 4 Guns of the Patriots. In 2010, Peace Walker. In 2014, Ground Zeroes. In 2015, The Phantom Pain. So this is the one that were talking earlier. The Phantom Pain is also Kojima's pain.
I have the collector's edition for that game.
Yeah, I played it. It's pretty good, at least in the beginning. It's very cinematic, like as every other game is on this series. But
and I think it's the first chronological, I mean, in the story. The Phantom Pain would be the first. It's happened in the 70s, as I remember now.
Yeah, the story is in somehow in a parallel universe where the Cold War is still ongoing.
But I think if you want to play the game in order of the events, let's say.
Okay. Yeah, let me try to see what order would be.
That would be the first. I mean, the last, yeah. Last one. Can I jump? No.
This game popularized the stealth games. So this was not, I don't think it's the first stealth game ever made, but it's one of the games that made this genre more popular. And not everybody enjoyed this kind of games. If you are like a Doom guy, you're never gonna like this type of game. Maybe not never, but you would prefer some... Yeah. Didn't expect that.
I wanted to kill him, but I didn't know about the other guys. Yeah. It's a cool game if you have the patience to go through it. Yeah, of course.
Yeah, you need to have a lot of patience in order to discover the story, but it's worth it. It's one of the best games ever made, and one of the best series ever made. So it's very impressive what they could do in that time.
Did you played also the remake?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, maybe something to try. The remake.
I'm looking at the reviews and it was 5 stars all over. It was a very well received game.
This one or the remake?
This one. The original.
Even the remake, if I remember correctly, had some good reviews. And if you are talking about reviews, let's check how this first version of Metal Gear Solid.